Hey everybody, my name is Shana and welcome to my Shana Mawachinal. Today is Friday, you know what that means. Tuesdays and Fridays are my recording days. Before I get started into today's video, I would just like to thank everybody for taking time out of the day to watch or listen. I want to thank all my subscribers, even though it is a small number. I enjoy recording and uploading twice a week, unless I'm busy, because anything can happen, really. And I also want to thank everybody for the birthday wishes on social media. And it feels a bit weird to be 28 years old, because in 2 years I'm going to be 30. And that is kind of why I decided to call this video "What You See Is Not What You Get." So even though I look like an average adult on the outside, I still have the mindset of a teenager or an older teen. It is hard to explain. I have a disability which is invisible. It is called fetal alcohol syndrome, or FAS. It is a very understudied disability. Not everybody knows about it. It is caused by when a woman drinks alcohol during pregnancy. And in my case, my mom also did drugs. I don't know much about her or my bio family. I have no idea. So my life is pretty much just going on little road trips and sometimes visiting my sister, hanging out with friends every once in a while, going shopping, going to the mall and movies, and just living my life as best as I can. Because even if you have a disability, or like, it doesn't matter if you have a disability or not, like, nobody's life is going to be 100% perfect. And people are always going to say something. There's just, I don't know, like, you can be the most kindest person in the world and somebody is always going to say or do something that's going to make you feel bad about yourself. That's life. It's not perfect. And living with FAS is just not my entire personality. It is just something that I live with. And some days are better than others. Life is weird, crazy, disturbing, and it's fun and it's beautiful. I think that everybody's weird in their own way. We all have dirty secrets, we all have weird habits. Like, humans are weird, and that's just the way it is, okay? You cannot control what people do in their life. You cannot control what people say. If you want people to say what you want to say, like, if you want to hear somebody's opinion, like, no, if you want to hear your opinion come from somebody's mouth, give them a script. I would love for somebody to walk up to me and I give them an opinion and they don't like it. I'm like, okay, I'll give you a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil. Tell me what you want me to say. Give me a script. Because at the hockey game on Saturday, where I spoke for the community living, I had a script. I didn't say anything on that paper just because of how nervous I was, even though it was a small group. I didn't read from the script. I didn't say anything that was on that paper. I was just too nervous. Okay. So I am PMSing just a little bit. Like, I'm breaking out here, I have a cold sore here, and mark here. I really didn't want to show myself on camera, but my toxic aunt came home early. She did not ruin my birthday, thankfully. And I was hoping to make a video at home today, but of course I'm at my dad's work. Anyways, back to the topic. Yeah, I look like an average 28-year-old on the outside. I don't look the best, but I'm me. I just have the mindset of a teen, and I don't play with toys. I have little toys at home and stuffed animals, and I love looking in the toy aisle when I go to the store. I can still do adult things, like regular things, shopping, going to the bank, running errands. Housework, yard work. I eat very slowly because I have a poor swallowing reflex. Now, every person who has been diagnosed with fetal alcohol syndrome is going to be different, so it's hard to understand and study. And I'm still learning so much about my disability so I can see if I relate to it or not. And hopefully later down the road, I would like to share my story with as many people as possible. And of course, I'm not going to get rid of this YouTube channel. I'm not going to get rid of my social media. I just want to share a little bit of my story every now and then. I have this little diagram here that one of my doctors drew. So this is pretty much everything. I'm just trying to make sure that you guys can see it. But these are my issues. I know I'm not supposed to be like laughing about it, but you know what? I think everybody who has a disability should be proud of themselves for being here on this earth and for being alive and for seeing how far they've come. Because I didn't think I was going to live to the age of 28. Not because like anything like too severe or anything bad was happening. I don't know. Like, I didn't think I was going to be alive at this age. And it's incredible. It's amazing and scary how fast time can fly by. Because my first memory is being in the crib. And I only have a few more minutes of recording, so I'm going to let you guys go now. This isn't the last time that I will be talking about my disability. I do talk about it every now and then just to remind you guys why I am the way I am and why, I don't know, mostly just who I am. I like to talk about it. Well, it's not like my entire personality, it's just something I live with, and I'm happy to be me. I hope you're happy to be you, and just live your truth, okay? Please continue to subscribe, like this video, comment down below, turn on the bell for notifications. My social media links will be down in the description box below. And I will add some notes. Well, I'll add whatever I forgot to say. And I hope to see you guys next time, because anything can happen. Peace.